image management is an intrinsic part of companies across the board. And when it comes to image management, when it comes to perception, gender diversity plays a critical role. A Credit Suisse report says that the companies where even one woman is on the board of directors has got better ROI. When it comes to Indian real estate, historically, there has been a case of poor perception. Perception over the years have changed a bit. When Track2Realty did a survey 10 years back, nearly 80% women said that they don't want to work with a builder. There's a social stigma involved. In our latest survey, only 44% women find it perception issues. However, the larger issue is that there's a glass ceiling for women. Women are not encouraged to take on the leadership role in the real estate companies. Most of the real estate companies where women are at the helm of leadership, they are either developers' wives or their daughters. For an average women workforce, glass ceiling still exists. They are more kept in the support functions. Positions like receptionist, sales girls, they're not allowed to come on the leadership level. Then there are certain other challenges. Like in this survey, we took five critical elements: perception issues, entry barrier, work culture, risk and reward ratio, and work-life balance. On most of the scales, the Indian real estate fails. The only difference is that the perception issue has now come down. But work culture, the boardroom culture of real estate companies is not very conducive for women. In terms of risk and reward ratio, there is a gender bias. Post-COVID, when there was layoffs, at a time when work from home was the norm, most of the layoffs were with women workforce. This clearly shows there is a gender bias. Added to that, most of the women find real estate not a career choice for the long period of time. For them, it's mostly a stopgap arrangement. Critical issues like maternity leave, which is a basic requirement for any woman professional, is often denied in real estate. Most of the real estate companies ask women workforce to quit the job when they want to go for maternity leave. These are the areas where real estate lags behind. Problem is that this is one business which really need to work on its perception management. Real estate still lacks the trust and transparency. Presence of more and more women professionals can bring that much needed trust and transparency into the system. Unfortunately, most of the real estate companies don't function like corporates. They function like family-run businesses. And in family-run businesses, there is some sort of gender bias. There is some sort of patriarchal mindset. Real estate continues to be the last choice of women workforce for reasons which is actually hurting the cause of the business itself.